This is your Fox 47 News Flash.
Welcome to your Fox 47 News Flash from the Digital Newsroom. I'm Chris Lewis, and these are the top stories that we're following. Some mid-Michigan students are already back to learning. That's because one school in Jackson uses what's known as the balanced calendar, which means summer break is shorter with more time off during the school year. For the first time since March 13th, Jackson Public Schools had students ride the bus, come to school, and do the school day, said Jeff Beal, Jackson Public Schools superintendent. Hunt Elementary is the only school in the district that's on the balanced calendar, and Tuesday was their first day back. Beal said that the district is spending more than $1 million to make sure buildings and students are ready to learn in a COVID-19 world. To make social distancing work, only half the students will be in the building at a time. Teachers and staff must decide what kids go on what days, which Beal said is easier than it sounds. Teachers are having to switch how they teach every day. Every student is now provided an electronic device. Beal said that will help with the flipped model of education that's happening in the district. The other schools in Jackson Public Schools will start the school year on August 25th. As Michigan State University prepares to welcome back students both online and in person this fall, researchers are busy working to find new ways to test more students more efficiently on campus. It begins with a simple spit test. The kit can be done in the comfort of your home or dorm room. You spit into a large tube, and then we have a separate tube that has a small amount of viral transporter medium, which inactivates the virus, which reserves it so we can run it in the lab, said Jack Lipton, chair and professor of neuroscience at Michigan State University. Researchers will then take the sample and run it with the others. Lipton says this type of pool testing makes it easier to test more people with less resources. If the pool turns out to be positive, then you have to have each person in that group take a single test. By fall, Lipton plans to implement a COVID-19 surveillance testing to staff and students on campus by testing 2,000 people a day. By September, MSU will have a registration site available for students and staff and drop-off locations for the samples. There will be pickup and drop-off locations for test samples on MSU's campus. Results from the spit tests come back in 36 to 48 hours. There's some relief coming for renters who are facing eviction. Ingham County has received more than $2 million to help those who could be evicted. Holy Cross Services is working with Advent House Ministries, Capital Area Housing Partnership, and Legal Services of South Central Michigan to identify those tenants. If you've received a 7 or 30-day notice to quit for non-payment of rent for any time from March 1st onward up to December 31st, 2020, you may qualify for potential coronavirus relief. These funds can help you to cover that back rent, said Raleigh Van Fossen, executive director of the Capital Area Housing Partnership. This relief also applies to some people who are already in the legal process. Courts have only been hearing landlord-tenant cases for about a week in Ingham County, so there's no way to know how many people need help. However, Van Fossen says, according to the Census Bureau data, it could be as many as 20,000 households. In the near future, this money will run out. With no end in sight for the pandemic, tenants will likely need more help. The money needs to be spent quickly, though. It's only available through December 30th. The Catholic Diocese of Lansing is preparing for students to return to face-to-face learning. This decision comes as public schools are making the choice to teach virtual learning for the first portion of the school year. Superintendent of Catholic Schools for the Diocese of Lansing, Tom Maloney, said our school population is much smaller than our public school counterparts. All of our parish schools are in a parish campus. All of our parish schools are in a parish campus with additional rooms and spaces that they can utilize. This really affords us the opportunity to do the social distancing and have our full population back on campus. Students will have to social distance in the classrooms. Megan Laughlin Krusky, St. Thomas Aquinas School principal, said teachers will measure 6 feet between each desk. This will be easier to do now that she has downsized the classrooms. All students will be required to wear a mask, even the younger grades. Getting into the school will be different too. Families will have to fill out a form each morning proving that they are symptom-free. Maloney said that there has been an influx in enrollment inquiries as more and more public schools choose to go online. The coronavirus has changed all of our lives, and many people don't know where to turn for help. That's why Fox 47 News WSYM-TV created Rebound MidMichigan, everything you need to get back on track in one convenient place. From dealing with stress to unemployment to helping put food on your table, plus ways you can help in your own community. Rebound MidMichigan, everything you need to get you through these difficult times. We may have fallen, but we will rebound together. Visit fox47news.com/rebound to learn more. Learn more about all of these and all MidMichigan's breaking news on fox47news.com.